This is Dr. Usha, working as Associate Professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering of Dr. MGR Education Research Institute. So today, in the FDP, this is the last session. So today we have Mr. Chandrakant Dioda. So Sarah is working as Senior Technical Delivery Manager, DevOps, with Vestion Corporation Private Limited, based out of Pune. He has completed his Electronics and Instrumentation Science postgraduate from University of Pune in the year 2004. With a brief stint in technical sales markets, Chandrakant has been largely associated with software and IT industry in India, USA, and Japan for last 15 plus years, and have worked with various Indian and foreign companies, including Wipro Technologies, Johnson Control, Toshiba, etc. Chandrakant have been associated with and voluntarily conducting the Sahaja Yoga meditation programs and classes free of cost with various government organizations, colleges, schools, and private sector companies. So we welcome you, sir. Kindly take over the session.
Thank you, ma'am, for this warm welcome. I request you, please give me a presenter rights so that I can present my PPT.
Can you try now, sir, please?
Yes, thank you. Let me know if the screen is visible to you.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Oh, sound is clear.
Yeah, it's coming, sound is coming.
So, good afternoon, all respected participants. Today's session will be very interesting. We are going to learn about the Sahaja Yoga, stress management, meditation. And next 35 to 40 minutes is very interesting. If you give your 100%, I will say this session will transform your life. And I want this session to be little interactive, rather than one person speaking and you all are listening. We can have this session little interactive and we can understand some topic like what is a stress, what is emotional intelligence, what are the problem we are facing, and how we can resolve this naturally, how we can start a journey of peace with the Sahaja Yoga. So let me ask you one simple question. What is a stress and what are the main reason for stress in your life? You can unmute your mic or you can post your answer on chat, whichever is comfortable for you. What do you think? What are the main reason for stress in your life?
Heavy workload, sir.
Heavy workload, correct. What else? Only one reason?
No, timeless
okay,
activities.
Okay, less time, timeless activity. What else?
Unknown fear.
Unknown fear. Yes. What else?
From participant side, participants, you can unmute your mic and make this session to be interactive. And please take care of it. You should not have any disturbances at your side.
Okay. So there is a answer in chat. Too much beliefs. Okay. Yes. What else? I'm not getting the exact reason or the topmost reason for the stress. If you give me the exact answer, we can move forward. Sorrow, no, not correct. Unnatural expectation, not correct. Yeah, that is all there. It is true, but this is not the main reason for stress. Unplanned, no. What else? Our own mind, not true, but you are on the right track. Maybe Ravindra Kaur ma'am. Sir, sorry. Our thinking. Thank you. This is who? Naini Satish. Okay, thank you. You are almost correct. I can say 80 to 90%. So if you ask me, what is the main or first reason for stress is a thought. Second reason is a thought. And third reason is the thought. If there is a gap between your desire power and action power, then you will feel the stress. So let's understand how yoga will going to help you. Hope my voice is not creating an echo, right? Voice is okay? Okay. So now, if we understand the main reason for stress is a thought. Now, how these thoughts is the main reason? Let's understand shortly. But now we shift our focus. What is a meditation? Anyone want to share? What is a meditation? Dhyan kya hota hai?
Making our mind to be calm.
Wow, thank you, ma'am. Yes, meditation will be exactly whatever you told. It's making our mind calm. This will give as a benefit. If I want to say a simple definition of what is a meditation, or if I want to explain to someone what is a meditation, how I can explain very in a short or in a very beautiful way? A definition maybe. So Ravindra Kaur sir says peace of mind, that is also the benefit. Geeta ma'am says that is also benefit. Naini ma'am says concentration on our breath, that is pranayam, ma'am. That is we call as a pranayam. What else? Body calmness. That is also benefit.
To control our mind to a single walk.
To control our mind on
towards a single aim or a work,
maybe that is also benefit. Controlling our mind, that is also benefit. Relaxing our mind, that is also benefit. Okay, we can do this, or we can understand the answer of meditation with the practical part. We all know Buddha ji, Buddha, Mahavir, or Sant Nyaneshwar, or any saint, if they are doing a meditation, that is dhyan, they are sitting at some place, closing their eyes and doing a meditation. So can we do that? Can you close your eyes for a few seconds and observe yourself what is going on? Kuch samay ke liye, kya hum apni aankhe band karke ध्यान करने की कोशिश कर सकते हैं? लेट्स ट्राई फॉर फ्यू सेकंड. अब हम अपनी आंखें खोल सकते हैं. लेट्स ओपन अवर आईज एंड कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट एग्जैक्टली गोइंग ऑन योर ब्रेन व्हेन यू क्लोज योर आईज. आपने जब अपनी आंखें बंद की थी तब क्या चालू था आपके दिमाग में? एनीवन? Anyone want to share their experience? What is going on inside your brain when you close your eyes? If you observe properly, when you close your eyes, you are getting a thoughts. Yes, Ashok Kumari sir, you are perfectly right. You are getting a lot of thoughts. And if you observe properly, this thought may be from the past or maybe future. हम कुछ ना कुछ भूतकाल का या कुछ भविष्य काल का सोच रहे हैं. मेरे साथ में ये हो गया, मेरे साथ में वो हो गया. अदरवाइज वी आर थिंकिंग अबाउट फ्यूचर. टुमारो आई एम गोइंग टू बाय दिस लैंड, टुमारो आई विल बी गोइंग टू बाय दिस हाउस, आई विल गोइंग टू ट्रैवल दिस प्लेस, समथिंग लाइक दिस. सो व्हाट हैपेंड, एवरी टाइम वी आर गेटिंग अ ह्यूज नंबर ऑफ थॉट्स एंड वी आर गेटिंग दिस थॉट्स कंटिन्यूअसली morning to evening. Maybe some thoughts gives a happiness to you and some thoughts give a sadness to you. But this thought cycle is continuously there. Then how we can go into the meditation state? Not possible. What is meditation? Meditation is the state of thoughtless awareness. And how we can achieve this state? If you observe the second diagram, there is a one thought, then there is no thought, and then another thought will start. So the gap between two thought, that particular state we call as thoughtless awareness, or we call as a meditation. In Hindi we call as a dhyan, in Sanskrit we call as a turiya. Jab hame koi bhi vichar nahi aate hai, hum nirvichar स्थिति में रहते हैं, उसी को हम ध्यान कहते हैं, उसी को हम मेडिटेशन कहते हैं. सो होप मेडिटेशन इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन. नाउ लेट्स मूव टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. व्हाट आर द बेनिफिट ऑफ मेडिटेशन और व्हाई शुड आई डू मेडिटेशन. नाउ वी अंडरस्टैंड द सिंपल डेफिनेशन, बट व्हाई शुड आई डू? Because I have a good job, I have a good salary, I have a home, car, everything is set for me. Then why should I do meditation? So let me explain you what are the benefits of meditation in our day-to-day life. See, we have a lot of work pressure. We are working morning to night. Because of this work pressure, we are working very hard. We are sitting in front of a laptop, in front of a TV, or maybe on a desk for 10 to 12 hours. And because of that, we are spoiling our health. We get the back pain, we get the neck pain, we get the headache. And how we are resolving? Nothing. Just we are going in a medical shop, taking a painkiller, and our pain goes away. And we thought that our problem is solved. No, my dear brother and sister, this is a wrong understanding. If you have a small pain, if your body structure gets disturbed because of work pressure, if you are taking antibiotics or a painkiller, it is giving a temporary relief. थोड़े समय के लिए आपको अच्छा लगेगा, but that medicine will create the problem in your body. For example, a simple painkiller, if you take, you will cure your pain for some time, but it will stimulate the kidney stone problem in your body. Similar way, any medicine you take, normal medicine or antibiotic, you will observe that there will be some kind of side effect. So do we have any mechanism within us which can resolve all our problem naturally? Yes. That mechanism exists within us, and that mechanism which we are going to study. And with that mechanism, with the meditation, we can resolve all our psychosomatic disease like blood pressure, diabetes, all kind of problem naturally without taking medicine. Let's say in our common life, the way we are working, because of too much work pressure, we are spoiling our personal life, professional life, and social life. If you are spoiling all this kind of life, you may frustrate, you may get angry, you do not have a time for yourself, your family, your health, And this will create a stress. You are always thinking about different thoughts. You are always thinking here and there. It will create a frustration. It will create an anger. So the way we need to clean our body every day by taking a bath, similar way, we need to balance ourselves. We need to remove all the negative thought every day. Because this negative thought may come from your friend circle, TV, newspaper, anywhere. And how we can clear this negative thought? By doing a meditation, by going into the thoughtless awareness. So dear friend, the stress is nothing but the silent killer. If you didn't handle properly, the stress will create a lot of problem to you and your success path in future. So we need to handle the stress in a very good way. So now we understand the meditation, we understand the benefit of meditation. So there are a huge number of benefits of meditation. For example, you all are doing exercise. And by doing exercise, you will get benefit. You all are agree with me. What is the next step of exercise? Maybe yogasana. If you do Surya Namaskar, you do the different kind of asana, you get much more benefit because it improves your muscles inside from your body. फिर योगासन के बाद का नेक्स्ट स्टेप क्या है? After the yogasan, the next step is a pranayam, breathing exercise. अगर आप breathing exercise करते हो, तो आपको योगासन से भी ज़्यादा benefit मिलते हैं. But after pranayam, what is the next step? After pranayam, the meditation is the last stage in human evolution. If you do meditation, you get the benefit of yogasan also and pranayam also. How we are doing a pranayam? We just simply watching a TV, YouTube channel, or watching some newspaper and following the instruction. But we don't know which pranayam is suitable for our body. What we are doing, simply following the TV or a newspaper. But there are a huge number of pranayam in the market. Which pranayam is good for you? We don't know. Simply we are doing anulom vilom, kapalbharti. That's it. But when you do meditation, whichever pranayam is required for your body will perform spontaneously and automatically. You don't need to take any effort. Effortless pranayam, that will happen automatically when you do a meditation. And that is the real pranayam. Okay? Because your body knows what breathing exercise is required for your body. Why we should do the anulom vilom kapal bharti forcefully and mechanically if your body knows the detail about yourself? So when you go to the meditation, the real pranayam will happen automatically and you get the benefit of pranayam also. And meditation has a huge benefit. If I start explaining the benefit, it will be like the 1 hour lecture will go only in the benefit. But my purpose is not to explain the benefit, but my purpose here to teach you the practical part, how to go into the meditation, how to achieve that state. Okay. So with this, we cover the meditation part. Now we cover the important part, which we call as a yoga. So now again, I will ask you one question. What is the yoga? Can someone please tell me? You can unmute your mic. You can post the answer on your chat. What is a yoga? Yes.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Hello, sir. Yoga means union with yourself, you know. Yog, judna. To unite.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Your name?
Jagdish Chand Pandey, sir.
Jagdish, sir.
Jagan, sir.
Bahut achha answer diya hai. Yoga yani union.
Ji, sir.
Yoga yani judna. This is the correct definition of yoga. Okay. Professor Karuna ma'am says rhythmic exercise of your body and breathe. No, ma'am, that is a yogasana or pranayam. But whatever the Jagdish sir told, it's a union or a connection. Only I want to correct his definition. maybe here and there, but whatever the answer, he has given a correct answer. So as Jagdish sir told, the yoga is union and a connection. So that is a correct answer. But what is this connection or what is this union? You should ask the question, ye connection kiske beech mein hai? Ya union kiske beech mein hai? So this connection or this union with your own energy, with the cosmic power, that is we call as a yoga. Now another question is, where is our own energy and where is located, how it look like? So our own energy is located at the bottom of spinal cord in a circular form. If you see this triangular bone, this triangular bone we call as a sacrum bone. The Greek people used to call as a sacrum. So this is a sacrum bone, and inside that there is a circular form of coil. The coil word in Sanskrit is called as a kundal, and since it's motherly energy, we call it as a kundalini. So this kundalini energy exists in each human being. The way we have a eyes, nose, two hands, two legs by birth, similarly, this kundalini energy exists in each human being, independent of sex, religions, any other thing. Every human being has this kundalini energy located in their spinal cord, at the bottom of spinal cord, which we call as a sacrum bone. But this energy is in a passive state, or it's in a sleeping state or a dormant state. But when we do some practical today, this energy get activated, and this energy transfer through the center channel and coming out from top of our head, that time the yoga will happen. That time the connection will happen. That time the union will happen. And once this union will happen, you get the thoughtless awareness. That is a meditation state. And you can feel a cool or hot breeze on your palm. That will indicate that your energy, that is your kundalini energy, get activated within your system. So how you will come to know? When you feel a cool or hot breeze on your top of your head and both of your palm, that time you will indicate, that time you will come to know, or you get the notification that, okay, your energy get activated. But if that energy didn't get activated, we don't feel this cool breeze or hot breeze. So today in practical, when we do practical, you will experience, once your energy get activated, you will feel the peace, you will feel the joy, you will feel the blessing. And that time your energy get activated and you get a thoughtless awareness. Now let me explain you a little more detail about our body system. In our body, we have internal body system. In our internal body system is made up of different nadis and channel. Hope my voice is clear. Oh, hello. Okay. Yes. Okay. So if you understand this subtle system, the way we have a physical body, in addition to our physical body, there is a subtle body composed of nadis, that is we call as a channel, and chakra, which we call as an energy center, and the kundalini, which is born with us and can be awakened spontaneously without effort. Just as a seed is transformed spontaneously into a green great tea, our physical, mental, and emotional balancing process is carried out effortlessly by meditation. We have a 7 chakra in our body. These 7 chakras are responsible for our physical, emotional, and mental well-being. Once we get our self-realization, we feel this center in our subtle system within us. As the kundalini rises and passes through this 6 center, which are our energy center in the spinal cord, and pierces through the frontal bone area on the top of our head, and it nourish, revitalize the center chakras, so that the person feel a relaxed, calm, full of life. At this stage, you can feel a cool breeze like a beautiful vibration start flowing through the fingertips, which the first experience of self-realization. Our Kundalini flow through the chakras. It energizes, it gives the energy, balance them. Each of our chakra is associated with the specific functions and qualities. A catch blockages, obstruction of a chakra, which prevent our Kundalini passing through that chakras. And if there is a blockages, we feel a hot or a hotness on our palm. As a result of the obstructed chakra does not function effectively, which causes our physical or emotional problem. If our energy could not pass properly because there is a some kind of problem or some kind of imbalance is associated with that particular body organ or particular chakra. So let's understand these chakras and nadis. So if you see the blue line, which we call as a Ida Nadi or a left sympathetic nervous system, it is associated with our desire power. The right channel, which you can see the yellow color, which we call as a right sympathetic nervous system, or a Pingla Nadi, which is associated with our action power. The center path, which we call as a Sushumna Nadi, or in scientific language, we call as a parasympathetic nervous system. Now, if you see the person in your surrounding, the person is very lethargic. He always focus on a past, over emotional person, always feel a depression and loneliness. That means that person has some kind of imbalance on his left side. Similar way, if you find a person who is an overactive person, thinking about future, workaholic, very aggressive, or a dominant person, that means he has some kind of imbalance in his right side. And Pingla Nadi mein koi to asantulan hai. But the person whose left side and right side is in completely balanced, that person is always thinking positive. Bahut shant manushya rehta hai wo, bahut balance rehta hai. Agar aap successful leader dekhoge, to bade bade decision bahut shant चित्त से लेते हैं और बहुत इजीली लेते हैं. दैट इज द क्वालिटी ऑफ बैलेंस पर्सन. लीडरशिप क्वालिटी विल कम व्हेन यू आर अ बैलेंस पर्सन. बहुत ही स्वीट रहते हैं, बड़े बड़े डिसीजन बहुत इजीली लेते हैं, बड़े बड़े प्रॉब्लम बहुत इजीली सॉल्व करते हैं, बिकॉज दे आर अ बैलेंस. यू कैन टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ग्रेट महात्मा गांधी, यू कैन टेक अ एग्जाम्पल ऑफ Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. They all are doing a meditation regularly in their life. I can give a number of leaders who are very successful and very balanced personality because of the meditation and yoga. So now this is all about our left channel, right channel. Let me show you one small video.
Sa means with, Ja means bond. So it is bond with you, the right, to become united, which is the yoga, with the divine. We have two sides in our system of autonomous nervous system, left and right, which we call as left and right sympathetic nervous system. The left side caters for our emotions, for our past, our desires. The right side caters for our action, physical and mental. If you indulge into one too much and go too far with it, you develop an imbalance within yourself. In the center lies the third power, which we call as parasympathetic nervous system. This is the channel which is the central path of ascent. When the Kundalini rises through it, it brings you in the balance because it rises in the center of the system. So this is the minimum that happens, that you develop your balance. This is the last breakthrough of our evolution, where you have to get connected with the divine. You have to feel it on your central nervous system, and that's how you get your self-realization.
So you have seen the video of the founder of Sahaj Yoga, that is Dr. Shri Nirmala Srivastava ji. She discovered the technique of Sahaj Yoga in 1970. She traveled across the world, explained this technique, and today millions and millions of people following this technique throughout the world. And this is totally free of charge. There is no charge. As Sri Mataji explained, you cannot charge any money for your own energy and natural process. So Kundalini is your own energy and awakening is a natural process. For that, Sri Mataji received a numerous award from across the world. And there is no hidden charges. There is no charges. This is totally free of charge. You go anywhere. So let's understand little more detail about chakras. So we understand the meditation, we understand the nadis, we understand the yoga. Now we understand the 7 energy center, which is located in our spinal cord. This energy center will be associated with our different body organ. So their name is Muladhara Chakra, Swadhisthana Chakra, Nabhi Chakra, Heart Chakra, Vishuddhi, Agya and Sahasra. So I would like to show you one small animation. If you can see this animation, so this is our sacrum bone, which is in a triangular shape. And inside that, there is a Kundalini energy. Once this energy gets activated, it goes to the first energy center, which we call as a Muladhara. This Muladhara chakra controls our reproductive organ or excretory organ. Also, it nourishes the Muladhara chakra. It manifests the quality of Muladhara chakra. After this Kundalini Shakti, once go from Muladhara, it goes to the next energy center, which we call as a Swadhisthana Chakra. This center is very important for us because it generates the gray cell, which is required for our brain. This center will be responsible for our memory power, concentration, creativity. Then third, it goes to the Nabhi Chakra, which control our all the digestion related organ like stomach, kidney, pancreas, liver. Then slowly it goes to the Heart Chakra. Heart Chakra gives the confidence within us. It control our blood purification. It control all our heart related organ. Then slowly it goes to the Vishuddhi Chakra, which is located at a throat location. It control our ear, nose, eyes, and all the sensing organ. Also, it improve our communication skill. It goes to the next energy center, which we call as the Agya Chakra. And from there, it goes to the top of our head, which we call as a Sahasrara Chakra or a limbic area. When the energy reaches there, you feel a cool or you feel a hot breeze. And that is the real experience of Sahaj Yoga. That is the real experience of Kundalini awakening. So this is all about the theory part. Why Sahaj Yoga is unique? Because with the Sahaj Yoga, you can be your own doctor. This is a completely natural technique, very scientific technique. It's a very spontaneous technique. No physical effort is required and it's a living process. So we all can do practical part. Now theory part is over. Now we can move to the practical part. But before that, I just want to check with you. All are ready for a practical part. Can we do the practical part? You can say yes on chat if you all are ready. Are you ready for practical part? Yes. So I can see only one yes. What else? What about other people? Yes. Okay. So can we do the practical part? Okay, that's good. So with your response, I can see all are still awake and we can do the practical part. Hope this is really interesting. So if you give a next 10 minute with 100% concentration, if you give the next 10 minute more than 100%, you will observe that a real transformation will happen within you. You will experience the real bliss. You will experience the real yoga, real meditation. So this is all about next 10 minutes. I want your next 10 minutes should be a 100% toward this session. If you give this 100% in next 10 minutes, you will observe the real transformation. First 1 or 2 minutes, I will be going to explain you the step that you can all learn and understand with open eyes. And then we can do this step with the closed eyes. Okay. So the step number one will be all the step you need to do with the right hand, and always your left hand will keep on your lap. Okay. So step one or a basic step, you keep your both the hand on your lap. Your spinal cord should be upright and straight. So this will be your base position. So step number one, raise your right hand, put on your heart little left side. This is the step number one. Step number two, raise your right hand, put on upper part of your abdomen. Step number three, raise your right hand, put on lower part of abdomen. You can see the step number three. Step number four, raise your right hand and put on upper part of abdomen. जहां पे हमारा रिब केज छाती और पेट जहां पे मिलता है वो पार्ट अपर पार्ट ऑफ एब्डोमेन. स्टेप नंबर फाइव, रेज अवर राइट हैंड, पुट ऑन अवर हार्ट लिटिल लेफ्ट साइड. सो स्टेप नंबर वन एंड फाइव यू कैन सी एग्जैक्टली सेम. स्टेप नंबर सिक्स, रेज योर राइट हैंड, मूव योर हैंड लिटिल बैक साइड ऑन द नेक फ्रॉम लेफ्ट साइड एंड मूव योर हेड लिटिल राइट साइड लाइक दिस. Step number seven, raise your right hand, put on your forehead horizontally, press it little bit hard and move our head little down. Step number eight, raise your right hand, put on back of your neck like this head and do relaxation. Step number nine, raise your right hand, press it little bit hard on top of your head, stretch your palm and rotate your palm 7 times clockwise direction. So these are the simple 9 steps we need to perform. After that, you will feel the real experience.
Please unmute my video.
Sorry?
Please unmute my video.
Maybe we all going to close our video. Maybe I request you all, go and stop their video. We can follow the instruction here. Okay, so next few minutes, I will request you, we can follow the instruction from this video. We will close our eyes. Maybe after this video will start, we will close our eyes and we can follow the instruction. Okay, so let's close our, once this video will start, we will close our eyes and we will follow the instruction quickly.
Keep your eyes closed. First of all, please put your right hand on your heart. All the time the left hand restores me. Now, here you have to say, in your heart, with all sincerity, Mother, am I the spirit? Ask the question 3 times in your heart. This is a very fundamental question. Now bring the right hand on to the left hand side of your stomach, in the upper part. Here press it. Now this is the center of your mastery, your guidance, your Guru Tattva, as they say. So ask a question, Mother, am I my own master? This is the question to be asked 3 times. Mother, am I my own master? Now, bring your right hand down below, in the lower part of the abdomen. Now, this is the center from which all the divine work is done. All the pure work is done. So to ask 6 times, because this center has got 6 petals. Mother, please give me pure knowledge. 6 times you just ask. As a result of this asking, the Kundalini starts getting awakened. Now to help the Kundalini rise, you have to cooperate with her. So please put your right hand on the left hand side in the upper part of your abdomen and press it on the stomach. Now here you have to say with full confidence to help the Kundalini to rise. Mother, I am my own master. This you have to say 10 times. These are the 10 commandments which you have to say. That, Mother, I am my own master. Times with full confidence. Now please raise your right hand to your heart. Now here you have to say again with full confidence, Mother, I am the spirit. This is the truth. You are the spirit. But you have to say with full confidence, Mother, I am the spirit. This you have to say 12 times. One has to know that God Almighty is the ocean of love. But above all, He is the ocean of forgiveness. So He forgives. Whatever wrong you do, He forgives. So don't feel guilty and put your right hand across on the left hand side in the corner which is made by your neck and your shoulder. Now here you have to say again with full confidence 16 times, Mother, I am not guilty. Please say it. Mother, I am not guilty. 16 times. I am not guilty at all. Please say it. Please say it. Raise your hand across on your forehead. And it's a very important center. Here you have to say from your heart, Mother, I forgive everyone. Please say it from your heart. How many times is not the point? Mother, I forgive everyone. Now some would say that is very difficult to forgive, but it's a myth that we do not forgive or we forgive. We do not do anything in both the cases, but if we don't forgive, then we play into wrong hands. So please say from your heart, Mother, I forgive everyone. Now please take your hand on the back agya, the same center, on the back side of your head and allow your head to rest on it and push it back a little bit. Now here, you have to say, for your satisfaction, because you always feel guilty, that, O Divine, if I have done anything wrong, please forgive me. Please forgive me. From your heart. Stretch your hand fully and put your center of your palm on top of the fontanel bone area, which was a very soft bone in your childhood. Press it hard. Press hard your scalp. Now you have to move it 7 times, saying one thing, which you have to ask for. Mother, please give us my self-realization, because I cannot force on you. So you have to ask for it. 7 times, press it hard and move it 7 times, very hard. Slowly, saying that.
Now slowly we can open our eyes. Slowly we can open our eyes. धीरे धीरे हम अपनी आंखें खोलेंगे. Let's slowly open our eyes. And observe our both the palm and top of our head. अपने दोनों हाथ और सर के ऊपर का तालु भाग हमें देखना है. Now we will do one experiment. Raise our right hand on top of our head like this. Move little up, down, left, right, and see if you can able to feel a cool or hot breeze. So I request you all participant, whoever possible, they can switch on their video just for 1 or 2 minutes. We can do this step together. So my humble request for all participant, if possible, you can switch on your video just for 1 or 2 minutes. Raise our right hand on top of our head like this. Move little up, down, left, right, and see if you can able to feel a cool or hot breeze coming from your head. Yes, perfectly right. So try to see if you can able to feel that. Thank you, sir. Sir, I can see you are doing perfectly right. Now take your right hand back to your lap. Try with the left hand. I request you all other participant, if you can do it, that will be very nice. Move little up, down, left, right. See if you can able to feel a cool or hot breeze. You can switch on your video just for 1 or 2 minutes if possible. Now take your left hand back to your lap. Try again with the right hand. See if you can able to feel a cool or hot breeze coming from your head. So thank you, sir. I can see you are doing perfectly right. Now one experiment you can do. You can do namaskar like this. And slowly open your palm, move little forward, close, and see if you can feel a cool or hot breeze coming from your head, coming from your palm. There is an energy. Did you feel this kind of energy? क्या आपको महसूस हो रहा है कुछ ठंडा या गर्म या कोई शक्ति आपके दोनों हाथों में? So here you will going to feel the energy. Whoever did it properly, they can feel the energy. Now I have posted one feedback form on a chart. If you fill this feedback form, you will get an automated email with the today's PPT and all other information and many more information. So yeah, Professor Karuna ma'am feels the yes energy is there. Dr. Hari Krishnan sir is also feeling a hot. That is very good. So now we have only two session is remaining, like how to practice at home and question answer session. So if you can have a list of question, you can post on the chat. We can explain you we can explain you all kind of question and answer, like how to manage our stress, how to cure blood pressure, diabetes, aging issue, eyes problem, memory loss, anything problem you are facing, we can have a cure. But meantime, I can request Ashok Kumar Mishra sir, you can explain how to meditate at home. Maybe the simple step which I am sharing the slide, you can explain how to meditate at home. You are there, Mishra sir?
Yes, I am here, but I am my video is unmuted.
Okay, you can explain on the slide directly. I have shared the slide. You can explain, sir.
The host has muted me.
Sir, no problem.
No, sir. Your video has got enabled. You can enable your video. Ashok Mishra, sir.
Yeah.
Yes. Now, not now, so, sir. Already we made it enabled.
See, how to meditate at your home is very simple. Sit down at a quiet place. And that is a good thing. No distraction, no disturbance. And if you are sitting on a chair, just see that your palms, left palms, is facing like this, and right palm is facing downwards or is hanging downward. Or if you are sitting on the floor, the figure shows like this, left and right palm touching the ground. Okay, this is the first step, and you have to say, we say Sri Mataji, you can say any god names, or you can say energy, cosmic energy, please clear my left channel. Clearing left channel, Ilya Nadi is important. So three times you have to say, please clear my left channel. And then after three times, put your right hand like this and left hand towards the sky. Here you have to say, please clear my right channel. Right? Three times. O Creator, O God, Sri Mataji, please clear my right channel. Three times you have to say, please clear my right channel. Please clear my right channel. Then both hands down and put your attention on top of your head. And then we can practice two more steps. Put your right hand on the left side of your heart and say, I am the spirit, 12 times. I am the spirit. 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 We are not body bound, so we are the spirit. You have to become the spirit. Now, right hand on the forehead, just bend your head slightly and forgive all. Forgiving all is very important, and you can now automatically forgive because your Kundalini power is giving you the strength of forgiving others. So several times you say, I forgive all. Sri Mataji, I forgive myself. Sri Mataji, I forgive all.
Ashok sir, only balancing, we need to explain the balancing, how to balance at home and then just sitting on a meditation. That's it.
Okay, so balancing part is over. Left side here, right side on the ground, and then right side in front and left side above, so that you clear the right channel and sit quietly for some time, keeping your attention on top. And you will see that you are coming into balance. You are neither on the left side or nor on the right side. You will be completely in balanced state of mind. And then we will meditate with Mr. Chandrakant will explain to you right now. Thank you.
Thank you. So all the respected participants, now it's a question answer. So how to meditate is just every day 5 to 10 minutes morning whenever you wake up, and every night whenever you go for sleep, you need to do this left side balancing, right side balancing, and just concentrate on top of your head and close your eyes and do meditation. If you do this, you will see a lot of changes in your life. You will see a lot of transformation in your life. So let's experience this. Let's enjoy this. And I will definitely say this will help you a lot in your day-to-day life. Okay. There is a question. Is there any yoga for children to improve their eye vision? Since nowadays, all of them are using a mobile and kids wear spec at early age itself. Very good questions. This specifically, this eyes problem will come because of the Agya chakra. This one, if there is a pressure on this Agya chakra, your eyes have a problem. So how to improve the eyesight? You need to improve your Agya chakra, which we call as optic chiasma. And to how to improve the optic chiasma or Agya chakra, what you need to do is just balance your left side, balance your right side, and do meditation. Along with this, there is a foot soak technique, but today we do not have that much time to do explain the foot soak technique. Maybe we can explain this foot soak technique little later, or maybe in future, or we can share you some video, because in today's session, this is introductory session, so it is not good idea to explain everything in a single session. So the foot soak technique is advanced technique. If you are interested to learn about more foot soak about foot soak technique, so what we usually do, we are doing meditation every Sunday morning 10 a.m. over Zoom, and I am sending that WhatsApp group. You can join this WhatsApp group and you can get the notification where we are teaching a little advanced step like foot soak and other technique that will going to help you. And I have posted my mobile number also. If you have any question, feel free to contact us. So this is a very good question. And this meditation can be done by any age children. We are doing for the lot of schools in the different part of India. And we observe that there are a lot of improvement in the kids. Their memory power increase, their eyesight reduce. And they are a very peaceful people. They are very peaceful kids. They, their results are very good. So these are the benefit you will get if you are a kids. If the senior citizen do, they get more benefit. So any more questions from the participant?
Sir, I want to add about eye problem.
Yeah, you can add. Yeah.
I have just come across a video where there is an interview going on by a television agency of a person who was who got automatically blinded some time back. And then the doctor said that there is a hole inside the eyes and it cannot be repaired, or you cannot get your eyesight back now. But after Sahaja Yoga meditation, his eyesight is 6x6. Full stop. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing this experience. Any other question, dear participant? Like, do you have any question? Why we feel a cold? Why we feel a hot? So, any other question? Feel free to ask if you have any question. Do not hesitate, because if you ask the question, it will be helpful to other people also. Any other question? Okay. So all the participant, did you find interesting? Did your thought has stopped for some time? Did you feel a peaceful in your heart, in your brain when you did the meditation? Did you enjoy this meditation? There are a lot of noise, I guess. Will be possible for host to mute all the other people?
I want to share my experience.
Just wait. Ashok sir. Is it possible to mute all other participants? Okay. So maybe Ashok sir, you want to share your experience? Maybe share in a short time, maybe 2-3
Yes, minutes. Yes. I have been practicing 25 years in Sajoga, and I don't want to leave any day without Sajoga meditation morning and evening. It just takes 10 minutes in the morning and 10 minutes in the evening. Now, the first benefit which I got from Sajoga meditation was my migraine problem got resolved. And I got a lot of confidence in my career life. And my attention was very strong, so I could manage discipline on the floor very easily. I was looking after export also, and we had a consignment which LC was expiring. And finally, because of our attention, the ship had some problem at the last moment, and our consignment was through. So all these types of stories are there. I'll give you my number. You can contact me. I can share more of my experience with you to convince you that Sajoga is the ultimate and to be practiced by everybody. It's all tied to people who are sick and very old, and it will benefit them in all wrong way. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Ashok Kumar Mishra sir. Your voice is a little problem. Okay. So any other question?
Here is the question from Dr. MJR Education and Research Institute. I am Dr. T.V. Anandan. Instead of saying the word repeatedly, can we mind or concentrating on the breadth of our inhalation and exhalation? Is it lead to reduce the stress?
Okay. So this word, doesn't matter this word. Thank you for asking this question. Very good question. This word doesn't matter. Like you can say any word. Actually, this real meditation will be effortless meditation. It will be a thoughtless meditation. So you should not have any kind of thought. Even not any concentration on breathing or anything. But since we are starting our journey, we are just starting today our journey. That is why what we are doing, we are just taking some kind of prayer which will help you to go inside. But this is not mandatory once you go and do practice regularly and you develop some kind of expertise. So even you can concentrate on breathing, but if you concentrate on breathing, your attention or your thought process goes toward that breathing exercise. And then again, you will observe that you cannot go into the thoughtless awareness. So what we are doing is like only for initial few days, we are trying to take a help of musical instrument. We are trying to take a help of this kind of prayer to go inside to your heart, inside to your spirit. And then after that, once you are a little expert, just sit, close your eyes and you go into the thoughtless awareness. You don't need any wording. You don't need any music. You don't need to concentrate anywhere. It should be effortless and it should be spontaneous. Just go to the thoughtless awareness. That's it. Hope I'm able to answer your question. Thank you, Dinesh, sir. It's a very good question. Because I feel this is a very deep question which you have asked, and it not help you, but it help other participant also to understand the real yoga or meditation. Thank you very much, sir. Any other question?
Sir, if it is possible, stop sharing, sir. Your face will be visible for others while answering.
Okay. Now.
Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So any other question? I'm very happy to share any more question will be there. Because I see a lot of question in other session, like people are like bombardment with a lot of question. But I see today a little less question. So we are happy because our work is less. So how much time we have, Geeta ma'am? Okay, there is a question from the Shiva Kumar sir. Who am I, sir? Please elaborate. Okay, this is very good question. Actually, all the people who are doing a meditation, who all are doing the yoga, they has to ask this question, who am I? Okay. And if you ask this question, who am I? You will get the answer in your meditation, who am I? Okay. So generally, we are a pure spirit. Okay. We are not this body. We are not this ego. We are not this anger, but we are the pure spirit. But what I will ask you, you can ask this question to yourself when you do meditation, and you will get the real answer in your meditation. So try to do this meditation. Once you are in a thoughtless awareness, you will get this answer. There is a question, does this chakra really exist or just imagination? This is very good question. Thank you for asking this question. Many people say, wanted to know, yes, this chakra exists within us, and this is a bunch of cells. Even you can, with the high instrument in hospital, you can watch their pulsation, you can watch their movements, everything is you can observe. So this chakra is not at all imagination. This is a real physical, biological thing which is exist in our spinal cord. And the proof of that, when this chakra goes in a balanced state, it generates some kind of wave. Like if you know the physics principle, each particle is generating a wave. Similar way, each chakra, because our body is made up of five elements, and when it comes into the balance, it is also generating a wave. And that wave, that is a high frequency electromagnetic wave, is coming from top of our head and both the palm. And that wave you can measure in any of the good hospital. The way, similar way, we can, these waves are generating from the chakras. And this chakra is exist within our body. So this is not at all imagination. This is a real practical part. Because if it's imagination, how come you feel a cool or a hot breeze on your palm and top of your head? So this is not real imagination. So thank you for asking this question. There is one more question. Where exactly our life spirit present in the body? What is the control of energy? Where exactly our life spirit present in the body? What is the control energy? Okay, there is a question from Shiva Kumar sir. So let me explain you. The spirit reside in our heart, little left side. Okay. I can go in a detailed explanation, but it will not be good for all the other participants to go on the particular topic in a very detailed way. But on a higher side, you can understand that the spirit reside in our left side, left heart, inside our heart. Okay. Then other question, I can take a little more time to answer in detail. So what is the... where exactly our life spirit present in the body, and what is the control energy? But before that, let me explain you where is our attention, or where is our chitta. In Hindi we call it as a chitta, in English we call it as a attention. Where is our attention in our body? Our attention in body is in our spinal cord, which is floating from our spinal cord. And what is the awareness? Awareness is located at tip of our attention. Let's say our attention goes to the particular city or particular person, then we get the awareness of that particular person. And this is how we come to know about any particular topic. So the spirit and our attention, which is exist within our body. And because of with this combination, we can understand all the thing. And this is how we can control our different energy channel. With our attention, we can control all our energy channel with all our detail. This is very high level answer I have given. But if you practice Sahaja Yoga, if you learn little more detail, so this is the little bit hypothesis for you at this moment. But maybe if I go and explaining, it will take a 30-35 minutes, but I don't want to go detail at this moment in introductory session. So let's understand this is at a hypothesis, and we can move forward a little more. Where we get the assessment link? Thank you. Oh, okay. Any other question? So Geeta ma'am, how much time we have still remaining?
It's already we are on, over sir time. We are on time.
Oh, we already over the okay. Yes. I'm sorry, I didn't know this.
But no issues.
So thank you, Geeta ma'am, for
thank
this
you, sir. Thank
opportunity
you
have given to us to interact with such a beautiful audience. Thank you, Dr. Usha ma'am, for giving this opportunity. I'm very happy. And today is a very introductory session. We could not able to complete the music therapy, foot soak, ice pack treatment, and many more. If you give us a future opportunity, we definitely
sure, sir, sure.
to take this forward. And we want to teach you more advanced technique. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
So, thank you very much, Chandrakant sir. Thank you very much. So nowadays, stress is a very great, major issue facing by all of us. So it's really a wonderful session, sir. Thank you so much.